Welcome to ZeroPage Homebrew, your best source for the newest Atari games. Mm-hmm. And tonight, we have an 8-bit game,
Yay.
And it is Prince of Persia that was released 2 days ago.
Wow.
Early Sunday morning. Mm-hmm. They've been working on it for 2 years, and it is quite the game.
Is it?
You will see.
Oh, I'm excited. Yeah.
So that's what we'll be playing today, because it's a big game. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to dedicate the whole show to it.
Okay.
It's programmed by Ren Soup, so, and a host of other people helped him. Mm. But that's the main programmer. I want to thank all the Twitch subscribers for tuning in. You can see them down the side supporting us. Alan the Fur, Armscar Coder, Atari HBR, Pocock, Bug Buck Owens, Canadian Tenor, Charles and Chuck, Charles Whelan, Chive, Five, Crossbow, Dan, AVC, Drexel, Dr. Mukals, Great Defender, Gretums, Ground Trip, Rosier, Rapper, Jedekai, Johnny, WC, One, Yerada, Garl, G, Kev, Kelly, Croco, 2600, Mark Space, Inc., Mick Muse, Mike Soul, Manclet, Tau, Miss Command, MK Smith, Mr. Zunderwoop, Mr. Fix, Neo, Media, Matt, Pack Rat, VG, Kohog, RC70, R100, Ghost, Repentless, VG, Rita, Show, Salaryman, Ricardo Pym, Six Sweets, Smitty B, Socrates, Spicer, Esmeres, The D-Train, The Lost Cartridge, The Welshman, Tiki Dan, K-Trek, MD, VHZC, X-Kenex, and Zebachi. And
wow.
You can support us too. Click subscribe and all that.
Wow.
Yeah, it's a lot of people.
It's a lot of subscribers.
More and more.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
That list gets harder and harder for James to read out.
I have to do it
it's
faster
treat time.
And faster.
Yum,
oh.
Yum, yum, yum.
Oh, yeah. It's treat time already.
Starting right off the bat.
48 cases. Wow. Well done.
Yes.
I did read it fairly fast. A couple stumbles there, but I got it.
All right.
Apparently, Vitoko wants to feed the cats
now.
All right.
Who's hungry?
So
are you hungry?
I can feed the cats while I do the news.
Oh, my goodness. Okay. Yep.
Get those cats swarming.
Yeah. Swarms. A swarm of cats.
Oh. So, upcoming, we have some huge shows.
Yes.
Four huge shows coming up. Four world exclusives for various platforms. The first one coming up is on a Friday show, which is the Halloween show. We're going to have an exclusive secret world premiere from Mick Muse, Mick Crocker, for the 2600. Then just added on the show after that on Tuesday, we're playing the exclusive world premiere of Kix by Champ Games, Johnny WC, John Champo. So I'm really looking forward to that. It is good. You just passed me the demo. Mmm. Tasty.
Tasty, make
sure you visit Champ Games booth, where you can play it too, at the end of October, which is pretty much now, at Music City Multicon. Also, on November 5th, which is the show after that, we have an exclusive secret world premiere from Muddy Funster, Lewis Hill, for the Atari 7800, with an interview. So he'll be on the show with us. And then on November 16th, we have exclusive world premieres for the Atari 8-bit / 5200. We'll be playing the 8-bit versions. And live interviews with Eric Anschutz, Robert Anschutz, and John Weisgerber. They were programmers in the 80s. And now they have revitalized their basic programs and turned them into assembly programs.
Nice.
And they've been slowly releasing them on the Atari Age forum. So we'll be doing some exclusives of, I believe, like their last four games that they're going to release this year. October, November are big months. Yes, they are. Some big stuff. So look forward to that. Mark it on your calendars or just go look at my calendar on the Atari Age forums. We do have a poll topic. Because we're playing a what I like to call ports, but what do you call them?
Oh, there are different names?
Well, there can be. I've heard a number of names, I've tried to compile the different names for programs that were on one thing, and now somebody's reprogrammed them for another thing, another platform.
I see. So, like, okay.
Yeah, so that's kind of the question. What term do you use when referring to a new game a newly released game based on one from another platform. So the options I've found are adaption, clone.
Yeah, I've heard clone before.
Conversion.
Yeah.
Copy. Not often used, but no. A copy, because they didn't really copy it.
Yeah.
They reprogrammed it all. The word I use, port.
Yeah.
Which is a very, very common word.
Yeah.
Number six, remake or demake.
Yes.
And that could be more specific.
I've heard demake before.
Demake's a bit more specific, where it's taken from a more powerful platform.
And brought
usually,
down.
And brought down to an earlier system. Platform. Yeah. Like, you take an arcade game and they demake it.
Or
yes. It's a more modern term. Thank you for following. Hi, Zeth.
Excellent.
Glad you're enjoying it.
Yes.
Yeah, demake is like, kind of scaled down, so the graphics are a little bit cruder to fit the thing they program it on. A good example would be Halo 2600, and that's a demake of Halo.
Definitely.
For the Xbox.
Yeah.
Put on the 2600.
Yeah.
It's a different game.
Yeah.
It's not 3D. It's a flat Zelda-like thing.
Yeah.
So remake, demake. I was gonna put other, but
yeah.
So you have to pick one.
No, there's
other
seven. You have other seven.
Oh, do I?
Other?
Oh, I didn't have it written down in here.
Yeah.
So if you have another one
you
that I didn't,
yeah.
You could pick seven and just type it. And you can pick multiple ones like Splendid Nut did.
Yep.
So we'll check back on that poll in a little bit.
Excellent.
So tonight we have Prince of Persia, which was, like I said, released 2 days ago. Is
okay.
For the Atari 8-bit system. They've been working on it for 2 years.
That's amazing.
Headed off by Ren Soup. His name is with two P's, but on the Atari Age forums, it only has one P. Somebody else take the one with two P's? I don't know why. A lot of other people helped him. TIX with character art in the Princess Room. Miker with music and sound effect. Vin's Cool with music. MK with sound effects. Mockery with sound effects. Super Rune for the title picture. And then a bunch of people he credited for using their programs, like a sound player, disc loader, assembler, all these kind of things. So this game was originally released on the Apple II. That was its first platform it was released on. And then it was released on a ton of other platforms.
Systems coming.
Like, I think around 20.
Okay.
So let's quickly look back at those so we know where it came from. And I've got a great video from Retro Sutro that I subscribe to them because they do a lot of game comparisons. So they take, like, here's the arcade, here's the 2600 version, here's the 7800 version.
They just show them the video, just pure video.
Usually in order of the release date of the platform that it was released on.
On, okay.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
So let's take a look at Prince of Persia Through the Ages.
Wow.
Which is a good way to kind of check it out so you know where it came from and where it ended up here. So here we go.
I know I have played this game. I don't recall what platform.
Well, you're one up on me. I have never played this game.
I'm
well aware of it.
Fairly certain I have.
So this is for the Apple II.
Okay.
This is the original title screen.
Wow.
The 8-bit version that we're going to play, they've done a new title screen, which was a point of contention. But we'll get to that. So let's get to the gameplay, because that's what we're really going to compare. So it has very, very fluid motion.
Yes. Yeah, the animation of the
of the character.
Of the prince, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it just looks absolutely amazing. Then there's the Amstrad CPC, which is a little bit more colorful. Very, very nice.
Mm-hmm.
No, Apple II was the first release. Amazingly enough. Yep. Then something called the Sam Coupe. They all look a little bit different.
Mm-hmm.
Then the Amiga. There we go. Well, Atari ST. Which looks like he's lit by candlelight at all times.
Oh, yeah.
An interesting look. He's kind of glowing with the yellow.
Yeah.
And then DOS version. Obviously not EGA. This looks like a VGA DOS version. And then it gets a little bit more modern. PC98. So these aren't really ones you would compare the one we're going to play to.
Yes.
Sharp, yeah. 6800. FM Towns. Buffer.
Getting there. TurboGrafx.
Yeah. Like, so these are like much more capable
versions. Yeah.
And you know, it goes to the Sega Master System.
The gameplay seems identical. Like, it's just a little bit more on the graphics side. Like, that's impressive. That's a little bit more in the background.
Look at that. Amazing. This is the SNES version. There's Sega CD, Macintosh, Sega Genesis, and well, let's go the Game Boy Color because that's going to be more in the level of what we're going to be seeing. Smack. Up he goes.
Game Boy Color.
Yeah. So that's a really cool look back at that. And what they based the graphics on, they redid everything in this game, especially the graphics. But what they said they based the graphics on is the BBC Master, which was not included on that comparison. Mm. Which is a computer. So there we go. So I think because the colors are completely different. This is quite bright, these colors. But they based the graphics on this and changed and tweaked the colors for the Atari 8-bit system. But is there a Switch version?
Yeah.
There actually is a lot of modern versions, too.
I'm sure.
Like, there's an Xbox and a lot of modern ones. But they were the more advanced-looking ones.
Of course,
they're not the same as the one we're going to be.
Not quite the same. Yeah. Re-imaginations of the original, probably.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So, that's kind of a look back at where it's come from.
Nice.
So, we'll be... Now, this program, you need 128K Atari 8-bit.
Okay.
Not a lot of people have 128K. You have to have a 65XE or a 130XE system. Or XL, sorry. Yeah, 65XE. And I don't have one of those.
Okay,
sadly.
Yeah.
So, we will be playing it emulated. I will be upgrading one of my systems to include more RAM. Mm. So
we'll not playing it on the hardware, but you know, maybe at some point in the future we will be able.
to, in the future, but not today.
Yeah.
And we'll be playing it in PAL mode, actually.
Okay.
Because Rensoup noted in the forums that NTSC downgrades the intro effects on the system, so it was actually programmed specifically for PAL.
For PAL.
Which I'll never be able to play.
Okay.
Unless
on
buy
your system. Yeah.
A PAL system, which it's very doubtful I would buy a PAL system. So we will be playing it.
We don't need PAL versions of all the systems you already have.
No, I do have some Japanese versions.
Yeah, I
but
know.
Those output...
I just can't imagine.
No, that'd be way too many things.
We don't have space for them.
We'd have to get another house.
Yes, we would.
With a dedicated game room.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yes. As nice as that would be.
So I think that's all I need to talk about before we get into the game.
Yeah.
Now, you have a choice here to play with either this big controller, if you want to get your stand.
Mm.
Or
see, what's my
you
other
can
option?
Play with this controller.
I'll play with this controller.
Okay. It is a heavy controller.
It is. I don't mind it, but...
It's a little much.
Yeah.
A little heavy.
We'll see how it goes.
Yeah. Okay, so you're plugged in. Will your XEGS memory be a memory expanded? I might do the XEGS, even though there's, I think, less room in the case. I don't know. I'll take a look. It might be easier to do on the 800XL, and I really like the look of that. But the other one with the detachable keyboard is also good,
because nice.
I can bring the keyboard right here in front of us.
Yeah.
Ooh, it's a toss-up right now. I might do the XEGS. I might do that. Yeah, that'd be fun.
The XEGS... needs some fixing, doesn't it?
CRC error is in the chat today.
Oh.
And he's the guy fixing it. So he's on it. He's almost got it done.
Oh, good.
No, it's not a DB9 adapter. It's just straight USB because we'll be emulating it, unfortunately. As I explained, we don't have a 128K system, unfortunately. Yeah. So you don't know what platform you played it on?
It could have been DOS. I mean, I recognize the game from, like, childhood high school. Like,
came out in 89 on the Apple II.
Yeah, and so
it'd be the early 90s.
I probably played it on a school computer, which is why I'm not sure what that would have been at that time. Right. So,
okay, so
I want to say I played it at school somewhere.
Are you ready? Here we go. Prince of Persia. So we're going to let it run through its demo. Intro sequence and stuff. Let me just make sure. Somebody's lost your ears off. 30 years late. The development cycle plagued by overinflated egos, existential tragedies, single SIO speed, and rodent invasions. Yet, it is finally available for your 128K Atari XEX... XLXE. Oh, it went away. Ah, most sought after unicorn for the Atari 8-bit.
Nice.
Prince of Persia.
Nice.
By Jordan Mechner. That was the original program.
Yeah.
Turban Edition. Be glad it happened. We are. We're very glad it happened. We have very nice intro.
Love the spinning Atari.
Oh, yeah. Credits for this skippable demo. Ren Soup with two keys.
Yeah.
Main code, DMSC, Elmer, XXL, or XXL, Macri Music, Checkered Ink, V5, Theus, Xamp, and gone. No pause. And that's it. You've just watched a bunch of effects. Each one running in 64K, coded back in 2019 to get familiar with the Atari 8 hardware before porting POP. So this, I believe, is his first game on the Atari 8-bit system.
Okay, that's cool.
I was trying to dig up some information on Rensu, and he has programmed in other platforms, and I'll get to that.
Okay.
So let's skip that. We've gone through the whole thing. Game sound randomizers. So there's different music banks and different sound effects banks that you can choose. Little rat.
Oh, I know. You missed the dancing girl.
Oh, yeah, sure. Prince of Persia, October 2021, final release. Don't touch anything.
Not touching.
For stock, Atari, Stun 30. Oh!
I didn't touch anything.
What is it? Bruderbund, right?
Bruderbund.
Yeah, because we watched some videos recently of somebody pronouncing it. I'm like, that's not the way I ever pronounced it.
I always said Broderbund.
Beautiful title screen.
Oh, yeah.
Slow rat in the corner.
Yeah.
That was a point of contention. we'll get to that.
Okay.
In the Sultan's absence, the Grand Vizier Jafar rules with the iron fist of tyranny. Only one obstacle remains between a Jafar and the throne, the Sultan's beautiful young daughter. Thought I had to read that fast because all the other screens were like, blink!
Yeah.
And there is the princess we have to rescue. Looks like a nice room, but if you're trapped in that room, it's not so nice. Nice view, starry night. The animation in this game is astounding. There is Jafar, the evil wizard. And there is our timer.
Ah.
We have 60 minutes to win the game.
Gotcha.
You have unlimited lives. So you can start over and over the same level, but you have total 60 minutes. Marry Jafar or die within the hour. All the princess's hopes are now rest on the brave youth she loves. Little does she know that he is...
He's already his prisoner. Yeah.
Tari Port Ren Soup. Ticks, I already listed those off. Not a lot of time for that.
It's all good. People can pause if they want to read them all.
Yep. So there's the options. We will leave it...
As is
for now.
Original, as per original intent.
Yep. So this is a small little demo.
Okay.
So you can jump.
Looks.
You can walk.
Lovely.
You can walk slowly.
Yeah.
You can hang from things.
Yeah.
You can actually crawl underneath things as well, and you can fight. with a sword.
And you just, I assume a one-button game?
It's a one-button game. Everything works with one button. The sword comes out automatically.
When you get close.
Foe.
Okay.
Yeah.
I vaguely.
The colors and shading look great. Yes.
So nice.
So amazing.
Yeah, the texture and everything.
Carl G says, reminds me of Sierra visuals in a good way. There we go. Okay. Press the button to start. And I will read the basic commands of how to play. So just moving around lets you run fast. To walk slow, you hold down the button.
Up
is jump. Yep. Hold down the button to walk and walk a little bit slow. Down's to crouch. Yep. Because you will have to walk slow.
How do you walk slow?
Press the button and move. There you go. One step at a time.
Okay.
And you can turn around and you can also hang. So turn around.
Oh.
You should learn how to hang before you go further.
Ah! Right,
get back up there.
I did not mean to do that. Okay, and then down.
There are way too many frames for the game of this era. Yeah. So, yeah, you can hang by going down. There you go.
Yeah, I'm not hanging, though. I automatically go down.
Oh, you don't hang. You go down.
Okay.
I don't think you can just hang.
Okay.
So, see those rumbly, rumbly
things?
Yeah,
they fall and you die.
They fall. So
you can run across them, but you
And they'll fall, but you'll get across. Yeah.
How do you jump?
Yeah, it's up to the right to jump across. There you go.
Up and to the right?
It wouldn't hang on. It wouldn't stand on those.
I wasn't trying to. I was trying
so
to jump.
So you lost one health out of the three.
How do you... Sorry, jump?
Up and to the right. Or up and to the left.
No. Up and to the right? Oh,
like
there
that.
We go.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. It's very, very picky.
Yep. Go a diagonal. Yes, diagonal.
That's Is
right.
it? No. That's weird.
Yeah, there you go.
Okay, that's fine.
Splendid Nut. Animation was rotoscoped from live action footage. Yeah, I actually watched that yesterday. He and his friends he filmed him and his friends doing all these actions. And then.
Nope.
You have to do it a little bit early, I find. Just a touch early than you think you should.
It's like jump into the right.
Yeah.
Jump into the right.
And
you have to kind of hit up and. Hit up and right and like left. Sorry, you have to hold that.
Yeah.
It's like up left.
Yeah.
It's diagonal doesn't seem to work very well.
Oh, whatever it is on that, up and right, up and left still works. So you'll want to hang from the right hand side on this one. Nope, no, no.
Oh.
You have to approach it slowly.
Oh yeah. Okay. This is gonna take me a little bit. It's a little different.
No, you don't have your sword yet.
No.
So I would run away from that guy.
Run away.
Because you will die.
I'm just kidding.
So I think we've got through all the commands already.
Okay.
Yep.
Oh, you have to walk, approach slowly.
Yeah, and then you can jump. Or you can run and jump too. Sounds way nicer than the PC speaker I had the first time I played this game. Yay! And there's pressure plates. That
yep.
you step on,
mm-hmm.
that will open or close the gates.
Oh.
Well, jumping up's not the worst thing in the world, right?
Yeah.
Quick, 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 quick. There you go.
No! I didn't do that. Oh,
controller says otherwise.
Yeah. Ah! Now I'm dead. Well, at least there's a potion.
I believe that's the action button.
Oh my goodness. Come on.
To get the potion. Yeah, there's no hanging from a ledge because I don't think there's ledge to ledge jumping. You just go down ledges.
Yeah. It's so weird the automatic run rather than the opposite is so opposite to modern games.
It is. Usually the button is run and you normally walk, right?
It's like, I guess it's the equivalent of like sneak.
Yes. Yeah, you're normally running but then you sneak. Now, this is actually his second big game that he made. The first game that he made.
No, no.
Oh. Was Karateka.
Okay.
Or Karateka, however you pronounce it. I played the hell out of that game. and won that game on the Commodore 64. This game was never made originally for the Commodore 64, but somebody did port it a couple of years ago to the C64. So I never got to play this back in the 90s when I had my C64. Probably because it was at the end of the lifespan of the C64, being an 89, right? Only the bravest warriors drink unknown liquids in strange bottles. Well, he was desperate. Okay, so let's read. Let's read a little bit about this. Sword fighting, we'll get to that when you get the sword. Oh, down the pit again. Kind of figured it out with Karateka. The art style kind of gives it away. Yes. Oh, yeah. Same exact look to the art. I mean, it's based on karate, so it'd be Karateka. Karateka, probably. The funny thing is, in that game, if you can run and you can walk, and you have to go into a running mode. Mm. And if you run into an opponent, he just goes punch and you're dead. But the end of the game, you have to rescue a princess as well. If you walk towards her, which is your fighting stance, she kicks you dead. You have to run to her, which is the opposite of what you've done the whole game.
Oh, funny.
So usually when people win the game, they're like, oh, I have to run to her, right?
Oh, that's
or I have
so
to walk to her,
funny.
Not run, because, you know, you get hurt when you run.
That's so funny.
So usually people die right at the end of the game. So funny. Any idea which graphics mode this is using? I actually have notes for that. They're old notes, but let's see. Oh, maybe they're newer notes. The graphics mode. The mode is used is 160 by 200, 16 kilobytes per screen. He was thinking about doubling it, but you'd have to find another 16K, which to get the full height. Thank you for following A8 Dog Dark. Atari 8 Dog Dark. Thank you. Glad you're enjoying it. So, let's learn a little bit about Prince of Persia while you fall in that pit over and over.
That's a different bit, but sure.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oh. Don't fall in the pits.
Oh, you always start back at the beginning, too. It's one of these games.
But if you make it to level 2, you stay in level 2.
True. Anything up here?
No. Nope. Just a wall to smash your face into.
Nah, just practice.
Prince of Persia is a fantasy cinematic platformer designed and implemented by Jordan Mechner for the Apple II and published by Bruderbund in 1989. Taking place in medieval Persia, players control an unnamed protagonist, but they did name him for the movies. I looked it up.
Oh, yeah.
Who played him in the movies?
What movie?
Prince of Persia.
Oh, Jake Gyllenhaal?
Yes, Jake Gyllenhaal.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yep.
Didn't see it. Didn't look good.
No, did not.
Like most games turn to movies. Yay. Players control an unnamed protagonist who must venture through the series of dungeons to defeat the Grand Vizier Jafar and save an imprisoned princess. Much like Karateka, Mechner's first game, Prince of Persia used rotoscoping for its fluid and realistic animation. For this, just like early Disney animations, too.
Mm.
They used a lot of rotoscoping. And they reused it over and over. The same rotoscoping in multiple movies. Mm. If you've ever seen that video where they compare like three different Disney movies.
Yeah.
And it's all the exact same actions. So funny. For this process, Mechner used as reference for the character's movements videos of his brother doing acrobatic stunts in white clothes. And swashbuckler films.
Just did the exact same thing again. It doesn't step one tile. It almost jumps over tiles. So I did the exact same thing because I thought I was one step away and I jumped right into the pit.
uses Mode E, bitmap 160 by 192, four colors plus sprites. Good old Mode E, Phaser Cat says. Not the five-color character mode. I expect one of the five-color character modes, probably the 4x16, one whose number I can't remember. Running and jumping is critical in this game to learn,
it
Atari 2600 dude
it's
says.
It's crazy.
Because it's all about the spacing.
Yeah.
So when you're doing
like,
stuff
like
that
you
just
have
crawl.
You have to do the slow walk,
yeah.
Which is crazy.
So when in doubt, use the slow walk.
Just almost like play the whole game with it, you know?
Pretty much, unless you're running down a whole hallway that you, or running over tiles that are going to fall, right?
Oh, I did it again. Again. You think you're, you it's just, it's all the pits. It's like you think you're less, you've got a whole tile away.
Pixel perfect platformer.
Oh my god, it's frustrating as hell.
It's almost there, but
it's so bad.
It's not quite like the early games where it's like literally pixel perfect platforming.
Yeah.
Where it's like, oh, you're one pixel off, you died.
Yeah.
Oh, you didn't jump where you're right at the edge where you could have died if you moved one more pixel.
Yeah,
but
it's
if you move
very
one,
close.
But if you move one pixel back, you can't make the jump.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
It's the whole like opposite of modern games now, which is like you're pushing the button to
walk slowly. Do this as well. I can change the up to a button if you want to try that.
No, it's not the jump.
So you don't have to press
I
up
keep
in
walking
the diagonal?
Into pits because I'm taking a full step instead of a half step.
Okay.
It's not the jump. The jump's fine.
The game was critically acclaimed, but not an immediate commercial success, as it was released at the tail end of the Apple II's relevance. It sold many copies, as it was ported to a wide range of platforms. It's believed to be the first cinematic platform and inspired many games in this subgenre, such as Another World. Its success led to
Oh my god!
Potion down there, I believe. To get back.
It's like, don't take... It, like, every step jumps over two tiles.
Yep.
It's really annoying.
E.T. pioneered this style of gameplay.
It's awful.
It's a potion down there.
Down where?
To the left, I believe. So falling one doesn't hurt you. Falling two hurts you. Falling
three kills you. Because
you
lose all of it. Yeah.
Rensoup has his icon as that... drinking the potion.
Oh,
he just
nice.
Drinks a potion over and over
yeah.
again. Don't go that way. Go that
no?
way.
Why
oh
not?
My god, there's nothing there. Go that way.
Oh,
pit
it's...
of death. Go back
oh,
where you
right.
came. No. Oh my god. Freaking me.
I wasn't going to jump, but I thought I could like go
there.
Down. Oh, okay.
Yeah. No.
No, I wouldn't have gone up down.
Two sequels, Prince of Persia 2, The Shadow and Flame, and Prince of Persia 3D, and two reboots of the series, first in 2003 with Prince of Persia Sands of Time, which led to three sequels of its own, and then again in 2008 with the identically titled Prince of Persia. And we're just talking about that. last night about things that just keep getting renamed over and over. It's like so confusing. Just run. Actually, no, you have to... Yeah. Oh,
no.
You have to stand on it, right? So, Rensoup originally posted November 26, 2019, saying, I decided to try porting Prince of Persia in early 2019. This port is based on the BBC Master port by BitShifters. And based on the original Apple II code by Jordan Mechner. So, the code for this game directly comes from the original game. So, I think you have to get right to the edge and then jump over.
Do I have one more step to the edge?
No. No, you do not.
No?
No, you do not.
I don't know. If
I wouldn't do it.
I don't
it.
Know if you're correct about that.
You're so close to the edge.
You're supposed to hang, right?
I
think I had one more step to the edge.
Maybe.
I think you were lying. Liar.
What does the audience think? There's a delay to your action. Preempt your moves.
Yeah.
A little bit.
You have to preempt.
The movement behind the pillars in the foreground is impressive, too. Yes, there was a... hurt yourself.
Okay.
I believe he had to, like, mask off some of the character for when he goes in behind the pillars.
Okay.
Because the character's in the foreground of things. So when he goes behind the pillars, he's still in the foreground, but you have to, like, get rid of part of the character. You had one more step. Really?
Yes, I did. See? Wow. Liar.
Not liar. Misinformed. Very. I don't want you to die.
I don't know. Sometimes.
Don't want you to die. I want you to make it to level two.
Yeah, there was one more step. There is your toe ends up off the edge.
Oh, it does. Wow. It does.
I was like, is there one more? I think there's one more.
So it takes very small steps. So on Sunday morning, very, very early in the morning, I believe they're in Europe. Squish. Oh, my back.
It always feels like he's
gonna get final release. Squished. All 14 levels. Game complete. TIX tweaked all the in-game animation frames and implemented all the cutscene animations. Finn's Cool attempted another tune set conversion with a great Asian vibe. Try it out or let the new sound randomizer choose for you. So you can change the sounds and the music. Oh, you're going to go for that extra help. Sparkler created an amazing title picture. Improved attract mode, cutscene and text screens. Mystery bonus. Don't know what that is. Apparently there are cheat codes in this game, but he hasn't posted them. I tried all the letter combinations.
Oh, did you?
I tried typing in Prince, Persia, P-O-P, everything. No idea. It's probably very obscure.
Up, down, left, right. No.
I actually did try that too. I literally tried that. Fix the NTSC palette. NTSC users can now enjoy more or less the same colors as PAL users. So originally PAL. We are playing the PAL version.
Keep what is going happening? Left.
Did you try some of ZPH? No, I don't think that's a thing. So step on that, and then it'll raise up.
Is this the one you have to jump over? No.
No, you have to step on it for a bit. So it raises up.
No, that's the one you have to jump over.
Oh, because
that's what I was saying. Is this the one you have to jump over? You're like, no.
Oh, I thought you meant that one.
That's not how it works.
Because that closes it. Yeah. Little tiles that open it, little tiles that close it. That's how close you can get to the edge, right? Yeah. Where your toes are over the edge. We can try ZPH, but it's not going to work. The 8-bit community is slowly learning about ZPH. Slowly, as we play more and more games. Ooh, your sword.
Ooh, very nice.
Don't fall down the pit, or that's your fate. Or you can go down there. And you can fall down there at least one. Or do it nicely.
I prefer that.
Don't sprain your... looked like a full wall there that you couldn't get through. So requirements, joystick strongly recommended. Keyboard is functional but barely supported. That's a funny statement. It totally works. Barely supported. PAL NTSC, Atari 800 plus incognito, 600XL, blah 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 blah. 128. Oh, I don't think you're gonna be getting that anytime soon.
I don't think so.
No.
Down we go. Oh come on.
You're going to have to turn around, step towards the edge, turn around again. Yeah. So dangerous. So dangerous. It's time to go fight.
I have to fight that guy, don't I?
Oh, something maybe down there. Yeah. That is a ledge. Careful. Oh, there is. Spikes and wall. Yeah.
Is there something on the far edge there?
That side? Maybe. Yeah. Because the other one, you walk through a wall, so it's possible. So walls are not always walls.
No, they're there not walls.
Oh, watch out.
Oh, yeah, I see it.
Now, you can walk slowly across those.
Slowly?
Yeah.
What do you mean?
Like that. You can walk slowly across them. Like don't run. Keep going.
What?
Keep slowly walking across it.
Are you serious?
Yeah. That's how you get across them.
You're dodging in between?
Yeah, you're like, I stepped there. But if you run, you're like, you're just dead. Oh, dead end. That's very dead end.
Is it?
Just wasting your time.
Whatever.
Unless there's a secret chamber, but I don't know. practice.
Nope.
Nostalgic 26. This is a different sort of platform. Careful movement with a relatively fragile protagonist.
Yes.
We're spoiled by the likes of Mario and Sonic, who can jump high and fall great distances.
Yeah.
That's true. Most modern games, you can just fall forever and you're totally fine. And usually the frustration comes when you go, oh, now I have to climb all the way back up, rather than, oh, you died. Mm-hmm. The early stuff is like, oh, you misstepped? Game over.
Yeah.
Too bad for you.
Yeah. No, you suck. You suck.
This is, I think you just press it.
Yeah, no,
it?
No, I was just looking around.
Oh, okay.
Is it this night?
So the first night? Playable level release was released November 30th, 2019. For this game. Here's Rensoup's programming background. A little bit I could find that he posted. He said, I started on the Atari ST, did a bit of SNES and X86 and a bunch more after that. And I actually found a program that he did on the C64. He started it or continued from somebody. I don't think it got finished, but it was a game called Sub Hunter. So if you want more of his programming, there's that game.
Hmm.
I think you can make it all the way across here. Not sure.
Oh, I did it in the wrong order.
Boo! You went right and then up?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I will let you read some more. I'll get it to
you
a point.
You can jump spikes while running.
Oh,
I see. Yeah.
That makes sense. For graphics using Mode E 161/192, 4 colors per sprites, for the main area, Mode F for the text line, Mode 4 for the status line. Okay. No. Okay.
No,
we're still
you can.
Playing.
No, you can play. I just wanted to. Like, this jumping thing is pissing me off. Not the jumping so much, but the. Yeah. Okay. So you have to get a run on and then jump. Well, sort of. No.
Just rotate it up.
You have to do both at the same time. I can see, yeah, it's like the diagonal, which is not so great with the D-pad. I think that's why.
My turn?
Yeah, it's all yours.
So here is a huge page of
stuff
tips and tricks. I'm not sure if I like using this, but
you don't have
we'll
to.
See.
You can switch it up.
We'll see how it goes. Might be okay.
Oh. Let's just see what people are saying.
So I never played this game.
You can jump spikes while running. That makes sense. You've never... Yeah, I know
back
I've played
day.
This, but it was a long time ago.
I was well aware of it. And I knew how impressive it looked. So you usually have to stand on them for a little bit, right?
It depends. Some... Usually, no. I don't think so.
Oh, what was that nonsense? I kind of caught the edge.
You didn't jump
as I
far
fell.
Enough. Yeah.
Yeah, but
you're
I'm
better off
talking
walking
about
over
the,
them.
About me kind of catching the edge because
yeah.
I didn't get injured, but I fell too.
No, but you caught it. You have to be going up or you drop.
Yeah, but I fell too, which didn't injure me.
Yeah, because you can fall one and then you caught it and then you
yeah.
fell another. So
yeah.
No, I don't think you. Yourself. This
but
is when
I
you
don't
have
know
to jump.
How I caught myself.
You have to go right to the edge and jump it.
Takes getting used to the controls. Once you know them, it's all natural.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's not too bad. I'm getting used to it. So one more. I'm just a little nervous about the up and to the diagonal.
Yeah, the diagonal's weird. Definitely weird. It's funny that the slow moving walk though.
He's careful,
it's,
right?
Yeah, no, it's just funny having to use. You almost want to just slow move walk everywhere.
Because his normal movement is so fast.
Tiptoe through the spikes. Exactly.
Because like I just press once and he moves like that far.
Yeah.
It's quite a distance. Oh, don't jump.
Yep. See. Difficulties. K. catching the edge. See, you jumped across it. You are supposed to be able to catch the edge. I don't know how to do that.
So those things reset, or I just never walked across those?
You never walked.
I jumped.
Yeah.
Is that opening the thing that's coming up, I guess?
I don't know. There you go. Good job.
Yep. Okay, I need... No!
See?
I didn't press up!
See? See how easy that is?
That's it for this joystick.
Aww. Yeah, only when you run through the spikes, apparently.
This makes clicks.
There you go. That's going to be easier for the jump because you can diagonal. You have to use the diagonal with that. I think that'll be better.
So if you could find where the fighting is.
Fighting? That, not life and death. Adventuring. Death and continuation. Hints? What am I looking for? Sword fighting?
Yeah. For when I get the sword again.
Okay.
And not die.
Hang from a ledge. Press the joystick button and hold it. Release it. Yeah. Ledge.
What kind of joysticks did the Apple II have?
To run and jump, you can jump further with a running start. For a running jump over a chasm, back up at least 2 full strides from the edge, push the joystick handle left or right to start running, and then up.
Oh.
So push up. Don't be afraid to push the joystick up too early. The prince will wait until the last possible moment to jump. So if you run forward, you'll run 2 strides and jump if you go left up.
Right.
Which makes sense.
So if I wanted to do it here.
No, you're too close. You need 2 full strides. You need 2 full strides. You weren't on the edge. A running jump is run, then jump.
Sorry, everyone.
Yeah.
We suck.
Apple II joysticks were analog. This must have been a nightmare to play on them.
I bet people use the keyboard.
Yeah, fighting is quite easy, especially the early levels. I think they were 2-button analog sticks. I remember many games asked you to calibrate by moving to the upper left, lower right, then center.
I remember doing that on some systems. Oh, what am I doing?
There you go.
Yep. I remember doing my calibration, joystick calibration, mostly on the PC. Because the PC had analog joysticks.
Yeah. I don't remember that.
Don't? What was that?
You walked forward.
Oh my god.
There you go. Yeah, you did catch the edge and you're going to fall down further. Yay! Oh, you don't even need it.
I'm going to not use that.
No. So it is the D-Train mention.
Yeah.
Oh, he's off anyway. Oh, sorry, right. We missed you. Not staring at the chat enough. He was asking why I was wearing a turtleneck if it was cold here.
It's not warm.
It's not warm. It's kind of getting into that ugly, rainy, coldy fall that Vancouver gets. So...
Yeah, we've had some windstorms here.
Chatting with a coworker today, and we were complaining about how depressing it gets in the fall winter in Vancouver with the rain.
You have to face the right way.
You do
for the sword, which is so weird.
Yeah,
like I'm standing over it.
You have to face it. You have to face it, I guess. So. If you are not right to the edge and jump, you can still grab onto the edge. Yeah, I couldn't quite figure out how to grab the edge though. I tried that with a different jump. I think I had those same windstorms yesterday, Phaser Cat Games says. Yeah, we had kind of a very windy, windy day. The last day.
We got...
Sunday, Monday, I think.
We weren't too bad where we are. What is that? What is that? I jumped up so I could rotate, and he, like, just fell.
You have to hit, like, the diagonal.
Oh, Oh my god.
He knows how I feel.
Yes.
Yeah. okay, do you want some
tricks?
Oh
my god, no.
No? You don't want tricks?
Well, maybe. We're not even to the point of tricks. Point of, like, using the bloody joystick.
To avoid fighting the guards, you can easily bypass them by moving towards them and therefore swapping them into the other side. Now put your sword down and run.
All right, not paying attention anymore.
Yep.
Everybody's giving up.
Fighting. Guard. Excuse me, sliding. Another great trick, this trick saves a lot of time and works when you have only two floors. You move left and right, then you are able to jump. Oh. Left, right, and then jump.
You can hop like a frog. I don't know if that comes into play anywhere in the game,
but... I don't
know,
maybe.
It's funny.
Maybe to keep you low. Hey!
What is he doing?
He's chewing the cord!
No!
This guy! He's a cord chewer. Shame, poor shame.
Shame.
Shame the cat. Cord.
What? I didn't press right! What is happening?
It's easier with the D-pad, I think.
I don't know about that.
Yeah.
Maybe. Yeah, this is like messing with me.
Oh my gosh, it goes through room.
Just so sensitive. Like, even bounce back from the joystick is messing up. Because you just touch it just a little bit. It's like, oh, you wanted to run right? Okay, you're gonna die. I mean, it's not... Don't! Oh my god! It did it again! What is that?
Are you walking forward slowly and jumping?
Watch that cat. I was walking slowly towards the pressure plate.
Yeah.
And then... What is that cat doing?
I don't know what he's doing. He's crazy.
He's looking for treats. What he's doing. And then I pressed to turn around and he just fell.
Night, Carl G.
Night, Carl G.
Oh.
You need tight controls for this game, apparently. I might even start playing with the keyboard in a second.
It's funny when you play games, and it's almost more frustrating when you know you've played it, and you know you've probably figured out how to play it well when you, like, a long time ago. I know I've played this game, and I know I've not done so badly, but it's just the learning the controls again. They're so different. Oh, are you gonna stay there or are you gonna chew? Are you there for chewing?
I'm here for chewing.
I'm here for chewing, he says.
Go this way. Don't fall into the pit. I just don't get it. Luckily, when you hold down the button, he only moves once. You have to press it in that direction again.
I think I need some wine. I think that might help this game. I'm going to be right back.
It would help it for me. For me too, but I don't
drink. Do you want some wine?
I don't want any wine. Let's take it nice and slow. The problem is, even if I take it slow, you press the slightest wrong thing, and he's like, no, I'm going to fall into this pit. And you can't stop him from falling into a pit, which is the problem. So you have to run this one, don't you? You can always blame Pal. It's the timing. I'm used to 60 hertz. That's the problem. So watch this. I can't pick it up this way. Look, watch this. I can't pick it up that way.
Yeah.
I'll turn around.
Towards it.
I can pick it up there.
But
I'm facing the blade. The other way I was facing the hilt.
I understand.
And it's like, why would you? That's so weird. So weird.
Sneezers.
55 minutes of practice, 5 minutes to save the princess.
Yes.
Yep.
Oh. There's like 8 levels or something, too.
14.
14! Good luck. We haven't passed level one. Well, hopefully...
So what do I do here?
So sneak forward.
Nah, I'm on the edge now, right?
Then you have to do a big jump and hang. There you go. Oh, you don't have to
Luckily,
hang.
I don't have to hang.
Okay. Then... Oh, gosh.
Nope.
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 Don't do it.
Is up, right? Yeah. Stop jumping.
So, yeah.
Not even pressing up. Not even pressing up.
I swear it counts your presses. Like, if you hold up, it'll jump multiple times. Ooh, very good, very good.
No, you piece of crap!
No.
I pressed... Oh my god.
51 minutes left?
Yeah.
Oh, I guess you have to restart the game. Meta looter.
I was going to wear my rage reset shirt tonight.
I think you probably
See,
should have.
I didn't press up there.
Anger.
It's keyboard
Anger.
Time.
It's a grumble cat.
Yep.
Hey, kitties. Come here. Someone come here.
Playing with the keyboard, everyone. Keyboards don't lie.
Oh, the keyboard. Yeah. See, to me, I'm pretty sure I played it on, I might have played it on a keyboard.
Oh, this is so much easier.
I might have played it on a keyboard.
Yeah, probably.
That actually sounds... Yeah, if it was DOS, yeah, there's actually a good chance that's what I did. Probably more authentic. Hey, cat. Are you tableting over there?
Tableting.
The tablet? 12. Level 12? 12 levels.
12 levels. I guess there's 14 things, maybe.
Yeah.
Oh, oops.
12 levels and then the bad guy at the end. Jafar.
Being too slow. The keyboard is 100 times easier.
Yeah.
Because there's just no mistakes.
Atari 2600D says, I can guarantee you will do better with the keyboard.
Oh, yeah. RDM. Like, it's just so much easier. Because I don't accidentally press up all the time.
Yeah. And holding the button.
It's a nightmare.
Because... You're not really pressing the button to jump. The button is just for picking stuff up and for slowing yourself down.
Yep, yep. Which you use
Which
a lot.
Which is kind of easier than, like, with a joystick button. Like, using whatever. That's okay.
What the heck? But I'm frustrated. Like, what just happened there? Is it because I'm letting go of something?
You walked forward, I think.
Because there was a buffer?
Maybe. Yes, there sometimes is.
That's probably it. It's like you have to stop doing everything, then proceed. Because I think I let go of the button first, and then it's like, oh, you want to walk? No, I don't want to walk. Don't. There was a guy who was playing this game for 4.5 hours. And he made it to...
4.5 hours?
He made it to the second to last level.
This version of this game, you mean?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, very good.
And Rensoup was laughing at how frustrated he was of...
of the jumping and stuff?
Just while playing it, because it's not easy. So I can get all my time. I wish to reclaim my time.
Yes.
No, go. I didn't turn around. I didn't do anything.
It says that's not what
happened. Okay, this is fighting time, so I need to learn about fighting, please. Mm-hmm. No, not on here. this paper.
Okay, sword fighting. To strike. Press the joystick button.
See? Better. Better. To fight, press the joystick, okay?
Yeah, the button. Yeah. To advance, push the button handle towards your opponent. What? Push the joystick handle. So, yeah.
Yep.
Towards your opponent, to advance, to retreat, away.
Yep.
To block your opponent's strike, push the joystick up.
Okay.
Just as your opponent is striking. So, instead of jumping, it may take some practice to get the timing right. Watch your opponent carefully and wait for him to strike. To stop fighting, push the joystick down.
To stop fighting? Oh, yeah. Okay.
Once you have put away your sword, you're free to run, jump, and climb as usual. Be careful, though. When you are off guard, a single sword blow can kill you.
Just the button to strike. That's your only move.
And you up to strike? Block. Yeah, but then there apparently is something where you can flip positions. Like, if you go towards him, you'll flip with him.
Oh, okay.
I don't know. Anyway. And then block is up.
But this one's, like, dead easy.
Oh.
Can I get things? I wish to have your robe.
Oh, my God. It's cold. This dungeon is cold.
Yes. I need a bigger robe.
Is that level two?
Level two. Keyboard for the win.
Trying to loot the body. Yes.
Yes, I am. I need more swords or something.
It's Skyrim. We need a wheel of cheese.
All the wheels of cheese.
All the wheels.
Hooray! Level two. Music. And the little ratty. Oh, cutscene. Watch, 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 watch. She's like, you wasted so much time with the joystick. You wasted so much time using a joystick. I should have sent a note.
Yeah.
To use the keyboard. Level two.
Mm-hmm.
47 minutes left. Pathetic.
That's okay.
Fall.
Oh, what are the yellow potions? Is that lives now? Do you actually have lives?
Oh, there's a bad guy there.
What? Oh. There is.
Hmm. Should I fight him right now?
No, it's up to you.
Well,
the yellow potion lives? Oh.
Yellow potion is his lives.
Note by carrier pigeon. Yep.
Red is mine. Looks a bit more aggressive. I learned from Karateka.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, he knocked me off. Does he come down?
He does. Down.
Get your sword out. Can you just... Oh, you do two strikes.
Oh, that's his life. I now realize what that is.
Right hand side.
I didn't realize that was his life. I was like, what is that?
But you start on level two.
Yeah. Thank goodness.
So he's a little bit more of an opponent. Oh, this is annoying because now I have to... Oh, actually, I think you can hit your head on these and it'll smack it down. Oh, God.
Oh, it injures you.
Unintended consequences.
Yeah. Oh, my. Oh, my. Ha, 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 ha. Metal Lunar says.
Well, I should advance.
Oh, you need to advance on him.
Get your sword out. I know, yeah. Oh, he's doing it over and over again. Oh, well, he's not advancing either.
No.
Weird.
You have to advance and hit him.
Oh, no. You beat the first level with the keyboard in your first attempt.
Yeah. Thank you, Atari 2016. So, way to be positive.
That's right. That's a good positivity there.
He's
so,
just watching you with amusement.
So I'm going to get just some advance.
Remember to... block if you can when he advances on you.
Well, you can either strike or block, but I'd rather strike.
Nope, he blocked you. Yay!
Squish you. Should I go down that passage down there?
There might be something down there. Or it could be spikes.
Go here. It's a little bit easier.
Nice. Can you get down there?
I don't need it. But it's there if I do.
It's there to come back to. Oh, watch for spikes.
Yep.
It's crazy you can walk through them.
It is. It's so it's unintuitive.
It's so funny.
Uh,
sword clang is very satisfying. Yes, nostalgic. It's a very nice sword clang. It is a very nice sound effect.
So
I feel like the potion should make a bubbly noise though. Bloop, 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 bloop. Like maybe when you walk into the screen.
Ah. Oh.
Oh. Oh.
It's kind of pushing it. Oh, I kind of move when I jump too. Oh, that's what happens. That's what's happened before.
Oh,
it didn't hurt me.
Oh, you almost got spiked.
I jumped once. Yeah. When you jump, you move forward.
So
if you jump at the ledge, that's how I died before.
Yep. Because you didn't jump forward, God. You jumped up. Yeah.
Oh. Oh, more potion. They expect you to injure yourself on this level. That's for sure. And a brick wall.
Nice. Okay. That's just a hidden potion. There's no other way to get to it. You found the secret.
True.
Yeah.
So, go to the... Actually, I should do this. Go up on this ledge. Walking through spikes.
Yeah, I know. It's quite startling. Oh,
that's how... Okay, I have to jump from here.
And then hang.
Should I run and... How do you hang? What happened? I pressed nothing. I looked away and he's like, oh, I'm going to run forward. It's good I wasn't closer.
I feel like it's not far enough. I'm not even sure how you would... Anyway.
How do you hang? You're the one with the instructions. You have to help me.
I can help you. I thought you knew.
Nope. It doesn't say. I saw them hang in the demo.
To hang from a leg.
Oh, there it is.
Press the joystick button and hold it?
No. Jump and hang. Jump and hang. I don't think it has it. I'm going to have to run and jump.
I think you have to run. For a running jump over the chasm, back up at least 2 full strides from the edge. Did you?
Yeah. But I didn't have to hang. Maybe it's automatic. I don't know. You hang, just hold the button.
Yeah, but it's... Yeah, when you're
don't
you're using...
Don't jump!
When you're what using the hell? Joystick...
Oh, he didn't move enough.
Oh, he got you. Oh, you can run away.
I can, yeah. Yeah. Death tune. Yeah. So let's listen to the other sound effects. Oh, you can't do it while playing.
Oh. In the emulation?
Yeah.
Yeah, you don't want to.
No, run.
From memory to hang, you just hold the button. Yeah, I mean...
Hmm.
Probably easier with the keyboard, though.
Yeah.
I would think.
Stop it!
Is he doing that? Oh, you have to block him. Oh, no
problem. Yeah, I haven't tried any blocks. So maybe if you block him, you can strike after blocking?
I would think block, then hit was probably...
Yeah. Let's try that.
Practice it a bit here.
Oh, you have to press it each time. You have to be so fast to block. You have to be so fast. You have zero time to block. And the blocking is not like a constant block. Mm-hmm.
You have to time it. That's what it was saying. You have to time it really perfectly.
No, don't stop. Ugh. At least he got rid of the second one. Kitten, please.
Okay, destructive cat. More like a parry than a block. Yeah. Oh, he cried. He doesn't like being picked up.
But he's his own cat.
James? You want to see James get...
Demolished?
Beaten up.
In a sword fight?
By the guards over and over again? Oh, enough of that. He says, nope, I don't like that.
Go get that potion that's down here, I think.
Is it? I don't know if you've been down there.
Oh, maybe I haven't been down here. Stop it. Stop it.
Ugh!
He turned around in midair.
No.
Cartoon character.
Wait till he moves toward that's generally the best approach.
Yeah. Oh, didn't have my sword out. Because that's, what was down there? Did you see? I didn't even look.
No, I don't think there was potions, but yeah. There might be something down there. But... So fighting is like platforming in that it's about careful precision. Yeah. Yeah, it is very precise.
In Karateka, that's how you get the other guy.
Mm.
You wait till he moves, then you kick in the leg.
Yeah.
Works on every guy in the whole game.
Yeah.
Work, wait till he moves, kick him in the leg.
These cats are something else today. Are you enjoying Prince of Persia?
Yes,
I am. Are you being cute? I think you're being cute.
Am I at the edge?
I don't know.
I think I am. Should I run and jump? I think I have to run and jump. This is too far.
That's a pretty wide jump.
Yep.
Yeah, I wonder what the potion tasted like having sat there in the dungeon all this time. Yeah. Not good. It turned red.
It's gone bad.
In general, when liquids turn red, not a good sign.
It's just like Karateka. Your opponents always have more health than you. Mm. Or did he have three? I think he had three.
The potion is bubbling, so it is carbonated. Or it's a kombucha.
Blech.
So all the microorganisms have created that nice, lovely fizziness. So, yeah.
So I don't need another potion.
Later on, you will find a bigger health.
Oh, I knew it. I knew it, I knew it, I knew it.
I like doing that. Ah! So.
Jesus.
That's one way. Get the potion. Yeah. Boost you right by the potion.
But I have to climb up.
Or can you go down? Or is there something messed up?
There might be. I'll see.
B. Larson. Well, dungeon housekeeping is probably going through periodically and replacing the potions, one would think.
I don't need to do it.
Oh, no. Oh, can you jump up from there or will it kill you instantly?
If I fall down, it will.
Ah.
Don't.
No, it'll push you back. You've got to go far forward.
I pressed it.
Lies.
Rewind the video and you can see me pressing it. It was like, come on, move forward. And it was like, no, you're not moving forward.
Yeah, there is dungeon housekeeping. I mean, these are guards. This is a dungeon. It's not some random, like...
Oh, I know. You can't press it over and over again. You have to...
No, you have to time it.
I was just practicing.
Yum, 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 yum.
Yay! It's treat time! Thank you. Look at these kitties. Who's excited? Are you excited for yum yums?
It's treat time. Yum yum. Yum yum.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
How many rings is that?
That was three. He's like, I want four. Five. Five. He wants five treats.
Wow.
That is a hungry cat. There you go. Here you go. Thank you, Metal Lunar.
Oh, come on.
He's so good at that bell now. Aren't you? Yes.
That's why they give you all the potions. These guys are so hard.
No. Kitty.
Why do I stop every time? Stop it! Stop it.
So lazy, Pixel. It's like, oh no, you dropped it 4 inches from my face. I can't possibly lean over to eat it.
Oh, come on. Jesus Christ. This game is about precision.
Yeah.
Throughout the whole thing. Even, like, everything. There's no half-assing it.
Hit the bell. Didn't quite hit it properly. There we go, good kitty. Give them a couple more. you get a little chonky. You don't get too many.
Chonky, please.
It's like, that's what I'm working towards. Full chunk.
You almost have to collapse this little thing.
Oh.
Ooh.
Oh, that worked.
Because you have to go slowly towards the spikes.
Oh, true. Right? Yeah, you can't run across it. Okay, there you go. Lots of treats today. Yeah.
No, don't run yet. This is what is the problem.
Mm-hmm.
When you're sneaking,
mm-hmm.
you have to let go of the left key before the button. Mm-hmm. If you let go of the button first, he runs mm-hmm. because it's a new press. I don't know if the original was like that, but that's why I've been running after sneaking some of the times. Do you think Darcy would accept the ringing the bell to get nuts? He might. It's nut time.
Yeah.
It's
ding, 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 ding.
It's nut time.
See, we have to get Atari to ring the bell. Or sorry, Darcy to ring the bell, and Atari can throw
That's right.
Darcy nuts.
They can knock them off from shelves.
Yes, yes, yes.
From high shelves. A high shelf. Nuts for you.
Darcy rings the bell and Atari knocks nuts off the shelf. Yes, that would work. Although, let's face it, Atari would probably just eat the nuts, but that's yeah. okay too. Silly kitty kitties.
That looks like a pit, doesn't it?
Yep.
So,
I should just... Guard?
Yeah, but there's the pit. I just go as far forward as I can. Go, 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 go. Good. That's close.
Yay!
Full health still.
Woohoo!
In your face. In your face. In your face. Oh, so many guards.
Oh, what's that? It's a fancy potion.
Should I drink it?
I don't know. What does it do?
What is happening here? What is this pole here? Sense danger.
Oh no, you can't. Oh well, you don't need. You can't use it anyway.
Does anybody know what this potion is? I'm very frightened.
Invisibility. Instant death.
Maybe it's 2 health. I mean, I don't need anything, so I'm very scared of drinking it.
Yeah, may never see it again though.
Is that a bad potion?
I think it's a bad potion.
I think it's a bad potion.
Oh my.
Oh my god.
So you have to run a jump?
Yep.
Sure you don't want that potion?
No. Get out your sword! Getting better at fighting, at least. Oh, don't fall.
Phaser Cat Games, it's a chamber pot.
Wrong potion.
Atari 2600, dude, there was one that made you do opposite. Oh, God.
Oh, no, no,
can
no,
you
no.
imagine?
No.
I think
no.
you have to drink it just to see.
Oh, I don't want to. It's so far into this level.
It may give you superpowers, Miss Command says. Yes.
It may. Can you look it up?
Look it up on this?
On the tablet.
Oh, on the tablet.
Brown potion or
blue.
Potions.
Blue.
Potions in Prince of Persia. Oh, I can jump over this. See?
Oof.
See, I don't need to do all this stupidness. Slow walking. Oh, it's raining now.
It is really coming down out there. I was wondering what was going on for a second. I'm like, oh, your window must be open.
Yeah, because it just has been getting hot. It's a little cool now, though. Mm. You better get that potion. Okay, I'll get that potion. Maybe. We'll see. Don't jump! See, I'm getting faster and better. Faster and better. Now, should I, like, run and jump into this dude? I'm gonna hit my head. Go, go, go further, go further, go further. Oh my god, I turned around. I got past him. I wonder if I can run away from him. Nope, I cannot. Oh, I can. Does he follow me? Oh my god, he follows me. Now I can't see him. Oh, the potions. Bug. Bug. Found a bug.
Turn colors.
Lead the guy into the other room. Yeah. After you defeat him, both potions turn to just blue. That is funny. No, don't do that yet. I need this potion.
Yay, it's just a red potion. Well, I don't know what that one is.
You didn't find it? Potions in Prince of Persia?
It's giving me all kinds of wonderful walkthroughs, but no, I haven't found the answer to that question. Kay. It keeps bringing up other versions
of the game. I'm going
to drink it. And... it was poison!
Okay, well...
No.
That's what I thought, because it's like...
No, evil potions have blue.
Thanks.
It's one life. Thanks, Charles Whelan. We read that a little late. Oh, well.
Now I have one potion, one life left.
You can beat him.
I can't, technically, yes.
You can beat him. Or... Ooh.
Or I can just fall into a pit.
Or you can fall into a pit.
Because the screen changes, you have to jump immediately. Mm. Well, I won't be drinking that potion. I would have died anyway.
Probably. Too little, too late. Yes. That's why you always read the chat. Kitties. Hi.
All you have to do is press the button as soon as they move. Like,
yeah.
Immediately as they move. And you will be usually fine.
Well, either it clangs or...
Yeah.
Or you get it.
Because it automatically clams.
Stop it!
Bad cats.
Bad cats. Everyone out in the Twitter land is like, why are you hissing at us?
It's not you guys. It's a bad cat.
You.
No matter how much we hiss at him, he's like, cable. It's so worth it.
This is the good one. Good but angry. But he's good.
He's a grumpy cat.
You're grumpy. Yeah. And yeah. He's like, no! You will not hold me.
I am unholdable.
No. Yeah.
Oh, get out your sword.
What's up, kitty? Can you hear the rain? He can hear the rain.
So let me outside.
Oh,
I'm just being really cautious is what
I'm
doing.
Yeah, no kidding.
So, we...
Phaser Cat Games. I had a cat that would chew through speaker wires and only speaker wires.
Oh, boy.
That's brutal.
That's terrible.
No, he doesn't chew speaker wires. He has a preference for USB cables.
Braided, wired,
especially the braided ones. He loves the braided ones. And headphone cords that are really small and thin. He'll just snap them in half. Bad cat. Bad cat.
So we saw Dune last night in the theater.
Yes, we did. What was your feeling on Dune?
Most people don't care about if people say they liked it or not.
You can go through the bottom, too.
Oh, that's true. So I think we can say that much. We're not going to get into spoilers.
No. We won't do that.
Well, I want to.
You
not
want
spoilers,
to?
But...
No.
Don't,
no. I mean, Dune is a known story, so it's not like...
True.
People don't know where it's going. But...
It was fine. It was an action film. Two
hits. Twice.
I needed it.
Nice.
It was a generic action film, sadly. That's what I thought. The characters were underdeveloped. Acting was fine. Yeah.
Yeah.
CG was fantastic.
Stunning. Visually, it's gorgeous. It's worth seeing. Yeah. Like, I would say it's worth seeing.
So, no to that. That potion.
Yep. Yeah. The poison. Don't drink the poison.
How does I like the feeling of the 80s Dune movie better than this one. The atmosphere. Yeah.
The atmosphere is the very fun crazy of it. And fun.
This one is just...
The Lynch one.
Dull and...
It's not dull, but... If I were to describe it... God, potion, hiss at it, yeah.
Hiss. Whoa.
We've got him twice. That's a really good...
It's a good start.
Nice.
Oh my god, is this the end? Please, let it be the end. I have all my health and everything. Where's the end?
What was I going to say? Denis Villeneuve, did he do...
Blade Runner.
He did do Blade Runner. Like the
which so I liked.
The visuals...
What's that? Should I drink it? It's hidden, so I'm... Oh my god, how did I survive?
How did you not
die? Well, it's protected
by
spikes.
And you can go through the wall on the right there, too.
It's protected by spikes, so...
I'm worried about this. Oh, you drunk?
That was good.
You got an extra.
Yes, that was so good.
Ooh.
Does it persist forever, even if I die? It must. No, I guess it doesn't. Only if you finish the level.
Oh, really?
I bet.
Oh, maybe.
So you think I can go through this?
Yeah, there's...
Seems like backtracking.
That's, see when the wall's like that? You can go through it.
Mm.
Oh, it doesn't go anywhere. Mm. Careful.
This shows me there's a potion there.
Oh, that's true.
Give you an extra life. Yes,
yeah,
it did.
Yeah, that's really nice. We need extra lives in this game.
I like Blade Runner.
But Blade Runner, so I just want to say, aesthetically, it reminded me a lot of the Blade Runner 2022. No?
2046.
2046, whatever it was.
No. Blade Runner was colorful and...
No, but the feel of it, I feel like the tone and
moody.
Feel. But this one had that moodiness. Like, it reminded me of it a fair amount. And I'll tell you what it felt to me like was... it kind of reminded me of some of the modern Star Wars films.
Oh, 100%. Just like felt like a Star Wars film.
The feel and the visuals of one, and it wasn't exactly bad. Nope. It was beautiful, but it wasn't like the original Dune, which was really kind of creative and crazy.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
But, you know, I think most people would be just fine with it, watching the film.
It's not a bad film, but... Yeah, I think the main thing...
What?
Is there an up? No?
No.
Dead end? Oh.
Oh, thanks. 31 minutes left. It's like, by the way, you suck. Oh, there it is.
And you hurt yourself.
How do you... I think you have to run out of the way somehow.
So I liked it. It was worth seeing. It might be the other side.
Yeah.
Definitely. Oof.
Oh, boy.
You just have to get right to the edge.
There's...
No, there's a wall. You can go
but
through the wall
a,
on that
there's
edge.
There's a platform there, which I'm going to have to jump over. And there's going to be a gate on the right-hand side through this wall.
For sure.
Oh, this is where I die. This is where I die. Oh.
Oh, that's your exit.
Hmm.
Yeah, so you do definitely have to jump to that side and then
Should
jump
I
back.
Go check that area first?
It might... It might fall
I
down
bet
there.
That's, yeah.
I don't know.
I'm just going to do what I know I have to do. How do I do this?
No! Oh, this is a frustrating game.
Yep, you lose it.
Run and jump, I guess.
So close. Mm.
Anyway, I enjoyed Dune. It just, the characters felt a little dull.
Yeah.
I think that's the only way to really describe it is the characters felt a bit dull. But it's very beautiful.
Yep. Yes.
Replay value. Yeah, sure.
Yeah, lots of replay value here. We just finished watching something else too.
Squid Games?
Squid Games.
Yes.
Yes, we watched that too.
Yes.
I enjoyed that a lot more than...
than Dune?
Than Dune. Sad to say. It's just bland. Dune was just... Let's say it didn't leave a lasting impact. It was forgettable.
Yeah, which is kind of sad.
It was like, yeah, okay. It made a lot of sense, though. That was the thing. It was like, oh, okay, I understand everything.
Yeah. But it... Ooh, jeez!
It's just causing me trouble.
Yeah.
Okay, run. Nope, don't run too fast. I need to get that extra potion. Oh, maybe if I jump here. No.
It just shows you what's there. Showing.
But you have to actually be there to do it. Come on. Maybe if I have to turn around and do it.
Maybe.
I will fall, though.
You will fall.
But I'm only falling one. That is a very hard one to get.
Dangerous.
Timing.
Yeah.
I don't know how to get back from the, that left-hand side. Like, is that big enough of a jump that I just did?
Can you jump and hang? Maybe you have to jump and hang. Maybe you should practice jumping and hanging. Because it's two or three, I don't know. Maybe it's a jump and hang one.
Okay.
So you have to jump from the edge. Ouch. Why'd you do that?
Because I was practicing jumping and hanging.
I don't know how to jump and hang.
It didn't even make it there. Just the timing is just too hard to that.
Are you watching Squid Game with dubbed English or subtitles? Always subtitles. Is there a question? Always subtitles.
Always. I want to hear the actors. I don't want to hear some poor second-rate dubbing that doesn't match the voice and it's not the real person's voice. I can read. It's always subs. Always.
The only trouble with subtitles is you have to pay attention. So if it's a show that you would rather do other things and watch and listen to.
You shouldn't be watching it then if you're doing that.
No, but it just depends on what it is, you know? Like, Squid Game, you want to sit and watch. If it's like a soap opera or something, you might have it on in the background, but you cannot listen to a foreign language.
You should be watching something else if you don't want to pay attention. Like, I should get that. You should be watching it, listening to a podcast. But yeah,
some shows it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Subbed in Spanish.
Subbed in Spanish with Spanish subtitles
for English sentences.
That's interesting.
Interesting, yeah.
The problem with the English subtitles.
You can go across the bottom too.
That they were terrible. apparently, well, one, they were timed very poorly. Some things just went blink. It's like,
you couldn't even read it. Yeah, some of it, the subtitling wasn't that great.
The timing. And then there was a lot of cultural things, apparently, that was missing.
Yeah, and I guess that's kind of normal, though, because things do get translated.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's how you do it.
That's how you do it.
If you can.
Go, Jake Gyllenhaal.
Oh, I don't even need that.
Oh, drink the poison.
Actually, technically, you should jump across
that. Yeah, because then you could go back to it.
But you'd have to remember to jump across it again. Mm.
Mm-hmm. What did you think about it, Vitoko? Did you enjoy it?
Can I jump this far?
Yeah.
Can I come up here? No, you don't.
He just wants to scratch the couch.
I just want to destroy your couch.
Good job.
Thank you.
That.
Watched it within a week. Yeah, we did it in 2 days, I think.
Two or three. Yeah. Probably not making that jump back. Oh, wait, that's up to the...
Oh, yeah, I definitely wanted that because going forward... Is it? Is it there? No, it's later.
I don't know. Go. I don't know.
I think it's later.
I don't know. Might be the other side.
to the steps so carefully.
I know. There's the...
That's the health. Thing I need.
Yep. Atari Dude is up to episode 7. Yep.
Almost done then.
Yeah. It was good.
Diddly-diddly, don't die, because you lose it. I want to finish level 2.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to do a save state. I don't know how much time I have left. It's not enough to finish the game, though, unfortunately.
I don't think so. You almost want to start over.
You jinxed it. I did. Yeah. I did.
That's what happens.
Stop it.
Don't do that.
What do I have to do? I have to jump. I'm going to jump. Yeah, the movement becomes second nature after a while. Mm-hmm. The problem is...
Timing sometimes?
If you let go of... I think I've said it already. If you let go of... the slow movement button before you let go of the movement button, you start running. Which is why I've died a lot recently.
Good job.
The thing is, I've also learned, if you like kind of anticipate him moving towards you,
yeah,
the worst that's going to happen is he doesn't move.
Oh,
the best that's going to happen is you hit him.
Yeah.
So I've been doing that mostly.
Yeah, and it's worked well.
Oh, yeah. Because you can kind of figure out the movement, the timing a little bit. Because there's like a minimum and maximum time.
There you go.
Nice. Yep. Oh, God. So, yeah, don't do that. Don't jump into him. I thought,
I'll get nice and close. He just cuts you in half.
Yeah. He's like, oh, easy prey.
That's new, Vitoko says. Yeah, agreed.
That is very new.
So wow.
Don't do that.
Don't do that. So many exciting ways to die. That's what this game should be called.
A Thousand Ways to Die.
A Thousand Ways to Die. A Thousand and One Ways to Die.
Yep. I'll get that now, because I need it. There are some nice little potions here and there that, in case you mess up.
Talking about being chopped in half, later levels of guillotines that you have to go through.
Nice. That's what I like. Yeah. So you have to get the timing, run under them or crawl under them or... Oh my god. So don't jump into that guy without your sword out. Yeah, they have to make it so that you hit him. If you do that, if you strike just as he's moving towards you. Because otherwise you will just keep losing lives. Oh, I drank it anyway. But anyway, I showed you can jump over it.
Yeah.
And in case you need it. No, I'm going to...
Not a running jump.
No, you don't need it for this one. Sometimes you knock him two steps back.
Yeah. Stick him with the pointy end.
Yep, I've kind of figured out how to defeat enemies. Which is good, which is good. As long as I don't jump right into them. Very scared about that jump.
Yeah, me too. I don't know how you get back from that.
I don't even know what I'm gonna do. Should run and jump this one.
Think so?
Mm-hmm. It's amazing it can do all this timing and do the animation at the same time.
And it looks pretty good.
And it's so... What the hell was that? It's the buttons. Oh my god. Oh, there's... I need potions, please. This.
Yeah.
How do I run back across that? Is there a potion on this side? It's just a door. I think I better go look for potions. Or it doesn't even matter because I either die or I don't.
Unless you think there's something. Yeah.
Mm.
So, yeah, getting
how
over.
How do I get back? Don't do that! Look, my hands weren't even on it. You do jump. Okay. So
if you go left and jump, you'll jump off the edge or no? You're too close.
If I do a jump from here, is that far enough? Like, that looks like I do kind of two spaces. Is that enough? I don't think it's enough. I think, don't do that. Well, I gotta do it. Gotta run over there. See? It took him the whole thing.
Maybe... Can you hang? No. We don't know how to jump and hang.
I can hang down on that side, but it's a long pit.
But you, like, to jump... I don't know.
Jump
how far
and hang
can you jump?
Ledge.
If you go right to the edge, can you jump? No.
I can jump. Yeah.
Yeah, but you might fall straight down.
I think I do.
I think you do. Can you run and jump? No.
Yeah, you can run and jump. I have to be very quick and very precise, but I think I have to
like
do that.
run jump like.
No.
Nope.
I pressed it almost immediately. Like,
maybe it.
Like, see, I'm.
You're two.
I have to see. Look at that. That's what I did, and it. It waits too long to jump. Oh, you're not coming down here? Okay. I have to practice that jump. I'll defeat this guy and then practice it.
Mm.
Right on the edge of this thing.
I think you jump and hang on the ledge. Yeah, but I don't know how to do that. I think this is the...
I think you jump. Because it's not enough time.
So, if you're on the edge, How do you jump and hold the jump, maybe?
Let me go right to the edge of this.
Well, if you're right on the edge, you will jump fully across. But that's...
It's only, like, that far.
Yeah, but it's three. It's more than that.
More than that.
So it's, like, jumping from the other side of that pillar that's holding the floor up. Like, if you take another step.
Over here?
Yeah, okay, so...
And then jump this?
If you jump that, how far do you get? I bet you can hang.
And you'd hang on the one lower.
Maybe.
Not... Because I didn't hang on that one.
Yeah. Maybe.
Let's try that. Is there any place I can practice that?
I don't know. That's a good question.
I'll look for it somewhere in this game before I...
Oops.
Okay. Or I can do that.
There's nothing down on the right, right?
No, it's a hard time limit anyway. 18 minutes. Nope. Do you get more with a running jump? Yeah, you get a lot more.
The problem is that ledge, you can't run.
There's not enough time to do a running jump. Like, watch how... I'm going to run and jump. And watch how much room he needs.
Yeah.
I'm already off the ledge. That's what happens every single time I've tried to run and jump. And run, jump immediately.
Yeah.
He's already needs that much room.
Yeah.
And that's why I fall every time.
Yeah.
So I think it is a standing jump from the very furthest point, and then you hang on not the one across from you, but the one down and across. Da-da-da-da-da. This, there's no ledge though. If there's a ledge on that side that wasn't jutting out, I could practice it from here. I could still practice it from there.
Jumping over?
Yeah. And see how far, like, to see if I would probably make it there.
I don't think you'd make it there, but yeah.
Yep. Yep.
Can you hold?
You would.
Can
you
hold,
would. Look,
though?
Look at that.
Yeah, but can... Oh, to that edge.
Yeah, he even landed on it.
Oh.
So that's...
That's how you do it.
Yeah.
It's just a standing jump.
Normal stand and jump. So there we go.
Good.
Might make it to level 3.
Oh, fingers crossed.
Which is
got
where we'll
stop.
Got
a few more of these dudes to...
No, these aren't the problem anymore.
No?
No. It's keyboard mistakes and ledges. And not paying attention.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
You hit me. Yep, I was too slow on the draw.
Yeah.
I'll go get a potion.
There's potions.
Yeah.
There's potions.
I'm right here. I have to run across this because I don't want to fall that far. I can continue on from across here.
Yeah. It's interesting that part of the puzzle in this game is mastering your own movements. It really is.
Mm-hmm. Oh, didn't think I'd hit him from there. Da, 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 da. I think that's Kartika. It's just barely different.
Nope.
Don't need it.
True.
Can't use it. it here?
No. Okay. No, it's the platform that's after this guy.
I can't be pushed nice back anymore.
Red vest.
You can actually change the color of his vest.
Oh yeah, I saw that.
That was very, very risky because if he hit me once, he'd push me back.
Other side.
Memorization is not my strong suit.
Well, I've just been watching you. It's easier to watch someone and memorize what they're doing than to play it. I find because you're focused on the gameplay.
So much stuff.
Yeah.
Can you give me everything? Ooh, it does too. Yeah. Usually that does in video games.
Yes.
When you get a power up, you get everything.
You're like, woo, everything. I think that's nice.
Mm-hmm. Oh, swingy.
Mm-hmm. Don't remember that.
No, I've never done that before.
Yeah.
Usually I'm just like, yeah, get down. Oh, yeah, just jump. Run and jump from this. Just easier. A leg kick to help me out jumping.
No, what? Leg kick?
You did an involuntary little kick.
Did I?
Leg kick.
Like someone just did a reflex test on me?
Yep. Now, how do I...
Jump and run? I don't know.
Run. There we
Yay!
Go.
Yay!
First time.
Atari's like, what just happened?
What? Treats? What? What? You're giving me treats?
Yes.
No, we're not.
So you think, I think you'll make it to that level. Just don't walk forward, whatever you do.
Yeah.
Go right to the edge and jump.
Oh, the problem is... Oh, actually, I'm still on the thing, so...
Oh! Did you hold the edge? No.
I was pressing up.
Yeah.
Apparently, you're supposed to press to the right or the button.
I don't know. But we need to practice that. I don't know how you do it otherwise.
There's nothing here to practice it on, unfortunately. So close. I know.
But why?
That's how you do it, but how do you hang on to a ledge? Can you look it up, please?
I've tried. Didn't see anything there.
Just hang on to a ledge from a jump. This probably might be the wording. Got to hold that edge. I know. Lance arms aren't strong. Oh, he hit me. What? When did he hit me? Just have to figure out how to hold on to that ledge. It isn't up, because that's what I did that time. It is not up. You'd think it'd be up, like pulling yourself up, but it's not. Unless I mistimed it somehow. This game's like... Ugh, don't jump. This game's like almost like Dragon's Lair.
You have to hold shift while jumping for the prince to grab onto ledges?
Oh. Shift, okay.
When he grabs on, you just have to pull yourself up by pressing up.
Okay, so you have to press the action button then. I mean, shift would be for whatever system they're talking about. Action button.
So walk slowly to the edge, stop, jump without any running. During the jump, while you're flying, hold shift and you will grab the ledge.
Okay, we got
shift.
It now.
So shift is the slow movement button?
Yeah, it's a different system, whatever you're reading.
Yeah.
It's probably the Apple.
There you go. So it isn't what you... part of the normal. It's not up. Because I kept trying up and up did nothing.
He didn't hit, the platform fell over you. Oh, the platform. Okay, thank you. I was wondering why I had one less.
Mm. Yeah, it did. It did. At the beginning. Yeah.
Is that the poll closing, or?
Oh, no. We didn't read the poll.
No, it's not closed yet.
Okay. Can you read it?
So far?
I'm pretty sure it's done. Nobody's going to be voting anymore.
So the winner for the poll,
yeah.
What term do you use when referring to a new game based on one from another platform?
Look at him. He's still drinking. Still drinking.
Is he?
Oh, no.
No, he's not. He was just standing.
Yeah. Looked like he was still drinking.
He's like still gulping down. Still gulping away. So the winner... by a pretty large margin, mm-hmm. is port number 5 at, I can't see, 48%. It's a little far
48,
away. 48%. Tied for second, adaption and conversion.
Yeah, conversion.
At 12. Oh, at, sorry. And also tied copy. Tied at 12.1%. Other at 6.1%. Clone at clone was 0%.
No, didn't think that would get any, but
yeah. And at 9% remake or remake. Yeah, sorry, it's far away and in very very small font, so
yeah,
a little hard to see.
I'll switch it really quick just so we have it on the screen.
There we go.
There you go. 4.85, 12, 12, 12, and 9, and 6.
Yep. Atari 2600, dude, I think you're almost out of time.
Yeah, I just want to finish this level and just so I
just can to get say, to level 3, yeah. It's been a long haul.
Yeah, I can see why the other guy did it for 4.5 hours.
Yeah.
And he probably has played this game before.
Yeah.
Whereas I have not.
Yeah.
So all these levels, they're exactly the same levels as every other port that's ever been done.
Every version of it, yeah.
So the person playing it knows exactly how to do everything. No!
I love how he screams at the character.
He's misbehaving.
I know. It's frustrating.
It is.
It's like, I didn't ask you to go there.
Yeah, and it's like life or death. There we go, 11 minutes.
Yeah.
I don't think they're like accurate minutes.
I don't know. Have we been playing one game the whole time? I don't think we have.
No, one game the whole time. We did restart at one point. Yeah. But I did continue your game.
Yeah. All right, so.
Moment of truth. Does the action button do what we want it to do?
Okay. So right to the edge.
Yep.
Oh yeah!
Have to hurry.
Finally. Yay, level 3.
Oh my god.
That took a lot of work.
I'm the winner! No. Level 3! Out of 12.
12! Oh my goodness.
So let's just explore and die.
You can go right to.
Yeah, you got it.
Thank you, Charles. 10 minutes for the end!
Yep. And some of the mazes get bigger and bigger, I'm sure.
Woo! Oh my.
And dead end. Oh, there
you
look
have
at
to
that.
Go all the way down. Interesting. Oh, same thing.
Yeah, but that one's not too bad. This must be a way to somewhere because. Should I go down first?
You could try down first. I mean.
It'll be easier going down first than.
And then coming.
Yeah. And going back up and down.
Oh my
goodness. Big. Big area. Just have to watch for those holes in the floor for spikes.
Oh, yeah, there was no cutscene. You're right.
Yeah, well, that's not everyone,
no
I guess.
No princessy cutscene.
No, I didn't earn it.
You didn't earn it.
I mean, they give you one at the beginning. It's like, okay, you passed level 1. That's good. That's
good
an incentive
job.
To keep going. This looks like the right way almost. Like it's a lot of things to do.
Yeah.
Anything up here? Nope. That's the roof.
Raise the roof.
That's right.
Oh. It's quite a... Ooh, that's smushy.
I pressed it.
Smushy.
Pressed it. Smushy. I'll play till my time runs out.
Yeah, sure. 10 minutes. Nine minutes.
Right back at the
door.
Yeah,
exactly.
They did that on purpose. No progress. For sure. Oh, no, don't go up there.
No progress made.
They're like, haha, here's the door you came in.
I think the movements are gorgeous, though.
Amazing.
I remember this game, and I remember it for how it looks, really.
Oh, you can barely make that. That's not the way.
Is there a?
Oh, a pressure plate? Nothing's standing up. I bet those things fall too.
Oh, can you run and grab the edge? There's no way.
No. Ah.
No. You have to open that somewhere else, probably down and around.
It
on
has
the
to
other
be
side.
A permanent opening, though.
Sorry?
Because there's no
yes.
way you can make it.
So
there.
It's probably down around,
yeah.
like at the bottom, it's in the area you didn't go. Don't drop the plate.
I have to get a running.
I bet. Yeah, from there, yeah.
Actually, I might as well just die.
Yeah, go left at the door instead of right. Yeah, true. That's
faster.
How you end up back at the beginning.
It's faster to just die.
Yeah. All right, left we go.
Oh!
Guillotines! Oops. Oh! That's hilarious!
I wonder if you have to run through it.
Maybe.
But you have to time out the running.
Oof.
Yeah, that was close.
That is frightening.
Chomp! Chomp, chomp,
chomp!
Chomp
is correct!
Chomp.
Yes, chomp is correct.
What's
over here? I bet that falls. Maybe.
Let's go up. We can.
Oh, is that the spikies?
Yep. Oh, okay, it's just the spikes. Okay, you're right. Oh, nope. Go up.
Sneak past the guillotine.
Oh, can you?
Can you?
What's that thing on the floor? That looks dangerous. What is that? Can I pick it up? What is it? Oh, it's just rocks. Just rocks. To deal with that on the way back.
Oh, that's how you get out.
What? Where's the pressure plate?
Maybe up there. Up there?
Could I get up there? From here?
Careful.
Oh my god. Well, I didn't see anything to do.
Nope. Maybe you have
Did
to go
I miss
up one?
Something?
Go over one.
Yeah. Oh, it's up.
Yeah, over and up. Yeah.
Oh, there might be something down too. Let's go down first.
Spikies.
Spikes down. Could be. I don't need that, so I'm gonna... What's happening here? Oh, pff. Okay. And hit my face on the wall.
Yeah, that's cute.
Must have been alcohol in there.
Drinky drinks.
Let's take a mute for the guards to get there. Yeah, it's they must have like secret passages that they can go through.
I think so. There's got to be walls in the back.
Because this is a bit insane.
Yeah.
It's like that where you look, they have, you know, like a movie or something, and there's all these.
Oh, wow. You have to go all the way around.
All these traps and things, and it's like so elaborate.
Yeah.
Okay, so what is happening? I must have missed something then, because I've seen...
You can go up that side?
Oh,
no?
Can I?
I don't know. Can you?
No.
Nope, maybe across?
I thought I saw everything. Oh, maybe here.
That's
oh,
a spike
yeah.
trap.
No, but I didn't go up here.
It's a spike trap.
Oh.
This is the spike trap.
Well, where do you open the door?
I don't know.
I've seen everything.
No, go back up. No, it's not... Can't be on the other side of the guillotine. The guillotine. The chompies.
I must have missed something.
So, you went up there and you couldn't go anywhere.
Yep. Went down there. It's just potion, which I got. It's nothing here. There's nothing there.
No, and that's a trap, I'm sure.
I can't. I could fall too.
No.
But I'll probably die. And that's it. And I've walked across all of this.
It must be all the way back then.
Yep. Right at the beginning. So I'm just going to die.
Maybe it was by... No, maybe... No, no. Maybe it... Don't die. I guess it doesn't matter. But I was going to say...
I'll run back then.
Run through the guillotine. It's by where that potion was in the far right bottom somewhere. Because you turned around and went, oh, I don't need that. So maybe it was down there.
Okay, I'm going to sneak through this. Somebody said they can sneak through it.
Okay. Oh, you can.
You can go right up to it, though. Oh. That's very scary. Okay, nothing here. Maybe it's down that right-hand side? Like, you go all the way down? Because I didn't go there. I just looked at it.
You looked at it. Yeah, maybe.
Don't. Probably what they do is like, oh, here's a potion. Oh, you don't need the potion. It's nothing. And then people turn around because they don't need the potion, right? No, it's a brick wall. No pressure plates.
No, but there's an upper part there. So when you go back up, right? Over to the right. 4 minutes left.
I didn't see that, though.
Yeah, I don't know. Try it.
Is there a leap of faith way at the top where you don't even see the ledge that you have to jump to? There is. Oh, my God.
Do you think there's a leap of faith?
There is. It's right there. Oh. You have to jump this way. So that's pretty clever.
There we go.
Oh, my goodness.
Doing kittens.
Kittens, what are you doing?
What did you do? Hi. How's it going? He's cute.
Oh, cat? It's trouble.
My hair.
It's trouble is what he is.
He's eating my hair.
Trouble at every turn.
He likes to jinx things.
That's all the time you have?
No. Run.
That's ridiculous.
Run and jump. But you have to run and jump the whole way over. Not like that, though.
You have to have enough room to press up.
Wow, you gotta really want run, yeah.
It sounds like it's going very slowly closed.
It does. Like it probably
kept going
slow.
For a long time.
It probably is slow. Just pulled out my earring.
The cat?
No, I did.
Oh.
Not the cat. That would be mean. What a mean kitty.
Well, he could with his paw. Could catch it on it.
Would you? No, oh, you Jesus. Wouldn't do that, would you? No.
Run, coward. It's from Sinistar. one of the most requested ports that's never been made.
Oh.
It looks impossible to play. It looks so hard. I think you can jump from here. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I did is I let go of the buttons in the wrong order. So he's like, oh, you want to move forward?
3 minutes left.
And that's only part one. That's just a door. That's not the final door. I didn't see any guards in this level. I bet it's all just like movements.
Yeah.
Like this.
Hey, CRC.
Hey, CRC. Long dinner. Yeah. He said, just before we started, he was like, I'm going to go for dinner. I'll be right back. And he just came back.
Yeah. This game is amazing.
2 hours.
It does look, it looks really, really good.
So you let go of the movement, then that. Turn around. Go. I'm just gonna ignore that. Because
it's a you can run a little.
Yeah.
Just stop.
I have to run.
Do you?
Listen to it go. Listen to it go.
Nope. Nope. You do have to run it. Oh, smooshies.
How are you gonna make that in time?
What are you doing?
Stop chewing my hair.
Like, I would have to, like, jump. I bet those are planned out so you can just do jump. Yep. A long jump. Right away.
Yep.
And then run.
Is there an after dark today for level 3 and 4?
No, because I'm going to run out of time.
Yeah. You're going to have to start over again.
Like, you have infinite lives, but you don't have infinite time.
No.
On...
It's not like impossible or... kitten.
Impossible mission.
Impossible mission. I was like, is it Mission Impossible? Yes. No, it's Impossible Mission. Impossible Mission where... Every time you die, you lose time. So your time runs yes. out faster. Which I always thought was pretty ingenious. It's like, yeah, you don't actually die, but it takes a little while.
Jump?
To heal.
I just did a standing jump.
You didn't do it from the edge, though. I guess you do have to measure yourself up to the edge.
It's going to take too long to do that. It closes almost instantly.
37 seconds, 36.
Oh.
35.
You weren't at the edge. Yeah.
Yeah. Kitten. What are you up to?
Well, we'll see what happens when you run out of an hour of time. At least I can practice this part a little bit.
Leap of faith.
Go to the edge.
I think those you have to be precise.
Turn around, go to the edge, jump, go to the edge, jump, move forward one, jump, do a big jump.
And run.
And
run.
Just run and jump.
Run. Time your jump. Run. Nope.
Ah!
Ah!
The mouse.
Oh no.
Well, the sand has gone through.
Oh, she's gone.
Oh, she's gone. She's married. She's unhappily married ever after.
Mm, poor princess.
Is that the end scene? You just see an empty room.
She's yep, just not in the room anymore.
Oh, very, very good.
So much fun. So challenging. So, you've never played it before.
So challenging.
Very challenging game.
But really, really good. I could,
beautiful.
We'll play that again in After Dark.
I think so.
In the future.
Yep.
Now that we can probably breeze through level 1 and 2 like that.
Hopefully.
Oh, yeah.
Hopefully.
Very quick.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, thank you, Rod Castler. I don't know if I would say that I did a great job.
Took a while to get through two
levels.
And
I got better. I started learning... know how to play it.
Mm-hmm.
So some good stuff coming up on Zero Page in the next little bit. What is this mess? Oh, I made a mess. So the Halloween show is next on Friday.
Yes.
With an exclusive secret world premiere mm-hmm. from Mick Crocker mm-hmm. For the 2600. Then on next Tuesday is the Kix exclusive world premiere
mm-hmm.
from Champ Games, John Champo. And we'll also be playing 1942.
Oh, cool.
It's at a state where you can look at it. It's not really playable, but we're going to take a look at it anyway. That was on my most wanted list.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
Yes,
yeah.
And Al Nefer is working on that. Given the difficulty of the game and the controls, well done is dessert. Thank you.
Yeah.
I had to use the keyboard. The joystick is so useless.
Very hard, yeah.
It's because you accidentally keep pressing things. Then we're going to be having an interview with Lewis Hill, Muddy Funster, and an exclusive secret world premiere
nice.
For the 7800. And then a couple weeks later, some exclusive world premieres from two brothers, Eric and Robert Anschutz and John Weisgerber.
Nice.
For the 8-bit system.
Nice, 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 nice.
And then the holiday homebrew special.
Yay!
And then at some point, we're going to have another exclusive Secret World premiere with Matt Smith. Nice. And also an interview. Nice. So many. Like five. Before the end of the year, probably. Then next year, 4th Annual Atari Homebrew Awards.
Of course.
Just ordered the trophies.
Yay.
Actually, I'm doing the final approvals, and then they're
on
their way.
Then the trophies are on their way. Excellent. Yep. We have to order those nice and early.
Haunted
so.
House. We only play homebrews.
Oh, I see.
Not.
Is Haunted House an original then?
We've played Haunted House as well.
We
before.
Have. Okay.
Yeah. Some hack of it or something. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's the little guy that goes through the house, goes up and down the stairs. You have to collect things.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. And I haven't filled out all of the Halloween special games yet. Still to be determined. I got a bunch of suggestions, so. Mm-hmm. So there may be more.
Yeah.
If there's a Haunted House hack, we might put that in there as well.
Nice.
So I want to thank all the people who tuned in, whose name I didn't read at the top of the show, because I forgot.
That's okay. Aces.
Charles Whelan, Metal Lunar, Nostalgic 26, Dan FC, Rod Kassler, CRC Error, Vitoco, Rendered Ghost, Miss Command, Nostalgic.
It's Nostalgic.
Atari 2600 Dude, Phaser Cat Games, B. Larson,
Carl G was in there at the back.
Carl G, there we go. D-Train, Splendid Nut. And everyone else who was lurking.
Very nice.
Is there a hacker homebrew of Haunted House that looked like Adventure? I seem to remember something like that. Oh, interesting. Maybe if I'll look for that.
Yeah, that's cool. Yep. That sounds interesting.
Yep. So we're done. Have a good week, everyone. Mm-hmm. And we'll be back on Friday.
Mm-hmm.
Wear your costumes.
Yes.
Hopefully ours arrive.
Ooh, I don't know if ours are going to arrive. We'll have to do something.
We'll
have to go into the archive.
With whiskers.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Yeah.
And paper ears.
Paper ears.
You want to be Atari? You want to be Pixel?
Do you have a tux you can wear? A tux and put on some cat ears? There we go.
I have a black suit.
Yeah, we can make that work.
And I don't have a bow tie.
But he has a bow tie you could probably use.
Yeah, I have to clean that up. A lot of cat fur there. Yeah.
Well, we'll see. Maybe our costumes will arrive.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Anyway, see you on Friday for the Halloween show.
Yes.
See you then. Oh, greetings back to Chile. Bye-bye.
Yes, bye.